OM Yields, which is a service design project aiming to cultivate and support sustainable communities in our urban centres. So let's just start with a background about myself and Dave. So we're two designers from Brisbane, Australia, and we've come here today to present this project, which we started at university, and we're focusing on developing design solutions based around difficult to solve problems. And we chose to look at the idea of our cities and mobility within our cities. So the core of our project, the Urban Yield, focuses on answering this question: how do we support urban agriculture in our cities? So first we began with a study of food trends in our local context of Brisbane, Australia. Like any good designers, we began by immersing ourselves in our research, both studying trend forecasts and waking up the crack of dawn and following market schools to find out more about their transport logistics and the food supply needs. So the issues of food miles, food security, and waste in transport are all core findings from our research. Through investigating the systems in place, it helps support our own cities with network. So exploring these issues of food transport, particularly looking at the transportation of fresh produce, and that really helped us frame some key guidelines in developing an understanding of the core problems with how food is moved around in our city. The sheer quantity of produce that is brought into the surrounding agricultural areas to support our urban communities is rapidly rising. And so to it, and so as with that, it's the environmental impact of packaging, shipping, transporting, storing, and selling the products that we need to create. And also this issue of fresh produce, the demand for fresh produce in our urban hubs, is the demand from local cafes, bars, and restaurants striving to differentiate their products by selling fresh and locally sourced produce. With the unrivaled density of cafes, restaurants, and bars in cities such as Sydney and Melbourne in Australia, this demand and pressure for locally sourced and sustainably originated produce is on the rise. This is driven both by cafes striving to differentiate themselves by supplying this sort of produce, but also by the changing demands and expectations of customers every day. So continuing our research and research for answers surrounding our cities and the relationship of food, we explore the concept of urban agriculture, which is the growing of food in urban areas. So this can be having a backyard garden, participating in a community farm, or even some school programs. So this rapidly growing trend further emphasises for us the importance of facilitating and supporting the idea of locally sustainable grown agriculture within our urban communities.
So next we looked at the methods and technologies used to move food around our cities. We explored what transportation networks were in place already, as well as what mobile communities we could tap into in order to explore the opportunities. In one of the communities we found, the growing population of cyclists throughout Brisbane City every day. We discovered this thriving community within Brisbane, and they're making use of the copious bike paths and other river bridges in order to optimise their travel time and cut through the traffic and the mess of everyday commuting. We found that the number of cyclists in Brisbane is growing exponentially, and it spans a wide range of users, from casual riders to die-hard cycling users. This number is growing each year, supported by Australia's relatively forgiving climate and propensity for sports in the outdoors. And of course this makes sense. For the majority of Australians living in densely populated urban centres and using bikes as an alternative to traditional automotive commuting or inadequate public transport alternatives. Because of these key trends and factors, the result is a huge untapped community of active cyclists. And this is where it worked for us. Actually worked to solve the issues around food, miles and transportation while supporting urban agriculture practices and also utilising the community of active cyclists in Brisbane.
So we designed the Urban Yield. The Urban Yield is a service design project proposing a bicycle-based network through transport produce around Brisbane CBD and surrounding social and cultural hubs. The primary function of the Urban Yield system is to connect backyard gardens, urban agriculturals, and school programs to supply cafes, bars, and restaurants in that area. The project as a whole focuses on building and supporting sustainable practices in our urban community, providing products, systems and services in place to support and empower people to participate in these practices.
The project aims to connect two emerging trends, urban agriculture and bicycle urban, to produce an economically sound, environmentally conscious and community-orientated food mobility network. By providing a mobility infrastructure in the form of specialised cargo bikes, the system aims to promote urban agriculture practices and encourage community engagement in localised food production and distribution. Cargo bikes lend themselves to the low volume, high frequency pickups and deliveries in and around the city. The bikes can easily and efficiently navigate crowded on the city region and make use of the existing infrastructure, such as bikeways and bridges. And this is to optimise the routes between deliveries. And by moving small-scale food production closer to the heart of the city, issues of food miles, waste, and packaging can be minimised.
And all these aspects of the overview of the project, connecting growers, dispatching couriers, and supplying cafes and restaurants, all handled from a design custom application interface. This app acts as a cohesive link between the complex inputs and outputs of the service and the products. It helps to support the organisation in ways of jobs and deliveries and transfers of products throughout the city. The primary user of our system and service is, of course, the grower, and as such, their aspect of the app is designed to be as seamless as possible and support their growing habits. This app also provides a retail platform that allows growers to grow and sell their produce directly to restaurants, bars, and cafes, and share with other growers in the nearby community. Connecting growers come through producers through integrated social network, gives them individual insights into how agricultural products are happening around the world.
The core of the avenue of business relies on cafes and restaurants ordering produce grown by the individual ground. The restaurant section of the app allows staff to request produce, track seasonal harvest, and identify key growers in their area. The restaurants can tailor their menus to the site of contributing suppliers, as well as uploading menus to assist the growers in deciding what to plant.
And lastly, but almost most importantly, we designed a Korean application app to support the bicycle careers in picking up and delivering produce as a route to our city. So this part of the app allows cyclists to navigate their route, identify information on their pickups before they arrive, and also navigate their destination in time. This app also handles all the payments and streamlines the user interaction across all levels of the service. And since the project initial release, we brought the product design aspect of the user interface up. So using these skills we've developed as graphic designers, we overhauled the design of our bike to add more value to the user on both the system and the hardware.
The new Avenue of Life makes use of rotationally molded boxes. Using durable recycled plastic, boxes designed to support the exchange and handling of produce with innovative plastic retention straps. The boxes are designed to support and protect the produce and provide an easy means of swapping full and empty containers when delivered. The bike itself is designed to better suit the urban city street with a more durable and manufacturable design. The integrated tray system allows for modularity and enables the rider to adapt the configuration of the box and the lids to suit each delivery. Together, the updated bike design works to support and enhance the application and the system as a whole by delivering an efficient and durable design solution.
And although this project was originally designed to solve this issue of food and transport of food in our own city of Brisbane, Australia, we think the real value of this project, the business model and the design solution as a whole, will be applied and adapted to the US in context. These issues of food security, sustainability, and urban agricultural infrastructure should really not be unique to our home city of Brisbane, Australia. Globally, cities are becoming more and more bicycle friendly, and still basically the same issues in the unhealthy environment, our own local facility. Around the world, countries like Denmark, the mass majority of cycling activists, providing huge opportunity for capital potential to transport their own projects. As well as this, Apple Copenhagen is a leading culinary city. The ideal is local and sustainable source projects for the community jobs.
For us, returning to the Hong Kong has also reiterated the international application of this project. For cities like this one, growing more and more each day, the demands and pressure on infrastructure support food distribution will require disruptive innovation.
So that's it from us here at Neil. Remember, this presentation has changed the way you think about food and how it travels through the city to reach a plate. If you'd like to find out more, please feel free to get in touch or just grab a chat after the presentation.
Which is to retrofit other bikes. So the one you saw in the video is our first model for design for retrofit all lights.
Okay, I'd imagine that your market is places where food security is a problem, right? And so do you have any intention of expanding into developing countries? And in developing countries, internet connection or access to internet may be very expensive or just unstable for your app to work. And the bicycle, for the person to buy a bicycle, whilst they already have one, it may not be working perfectly, but it works. Purchasing your bicycle might be too expensive for them. And actually, those places will be the places where food security will be more severe. The problem is.
Yeah, it's a very good point. We really target this at developed nations originally. So we're looking at our own core city of Brisbane, Melbourne, Sydney, where it's a hugely dense urban population. And it's quite a high socioeconomic income as well. So really for us, this model is based on cafes, restaurants and bars wanting and needing to supply local produce. So it's a high value project and a high value product that they're offering. I think doesn't necessarily adapt properly to a lot of developing nations and developing areas.
The other point is in our research we found that lots of these communities already had an established distribution network of their own food. And so this one kind of focuses on cities that have to import, kind of get food transported daily from surrounding regions. So that's what we found in our research into developing countries. Yeah.
And really, Australia, the idea of growing food in your backyard is not really a way of sustaining your whole food source. It's more of an enjoyment aspect. As a cafe and restaurant, really latching on to this idea of supporting this local community and supplying food that is created and grown within the region. So it's almost a different aspect of agriculture from supporting the entire population. Locally produced food, more of an asset, and enhancing the food system and supply network.
So do you guys think there'd be kind of a peak season, or because it's really such nice weather, does food grow year-round?
There is seasonal aspects to the system, but what's sort of interesting will come out with more testing is how the consumers, or like growers, would adapt to the seasons to supply. So there might be, like take strawberries for example, they don't grow so well all year, but for the time of the year that they do grow, you probably see a peak in the growers trying to fulfill that.
Yeah. And we try to accommodate that as well with the application. So the app restaurant section of the app, UI allows the restaurants to upload seasonal menus to handle the products that people can suggest to grow, and also make use of the products that are available around both the region and the season.
That's a statistic that I
really find. It's really interesting because 90% of the population is in the LA, but all of our food supply comes from the surroundings, so agricultural areas, which are probably an hour out of the city. So, Brisbane, for example, there's very little agriculture within CBD, if not at all, except for certain agricultural projects. So, Brisbane has 391 urban agricultural, growing areas, so there's schools, community farms, or just the agricultural. Even hydroponic setups, including that number. So for a city the size of Brisbane and Sydney and Melbourne, there's a huge density of population that's interested in this experience. I think people are getting more and more aware of the difficulty of transporting produce from these surrounding areas. So yeah, it's a growing trend, it's also become quite passionate. Yeah, you're aware of the food
side. That's like a new way of sort of
exactly. Yeah, and people are willing to spend more money on products as opposed to resource sustainable source as well.
Cool. And so the app and the whole platform itself, it's how we show it, is it a mock-up or it's in use right now? What's the stage?
So this is a mock-up at the stage. Product design, we built an MVP a while ago, and we can establish it and so we're in the recognition of seeds, but the app is still a mock-up stage.
It's definitely something that I think has a viable consumer application, I think, especially with the rise of farming. You said that more and more
awareness for locally sourced products.
Yeah, and it's also a lot of incentive from like the restaurant owners as well to be able to boast that their produce has been grown around the corner by Matthew. It's something that I think would really go well, I guess, in the research that we've done.
And we're really hoping that not only for the functional business, we have to really supply cafes and restaurants, but also encourage more people to behave with those unknown important practices. But if there's a business model in place that they can income or product consumption, or can leave income, or share products with us growers, it makes it more viable and more standard.
I think a big problem here would be a solution where you can offer an easy way to start it off around the farm.
Sure. Yes.
That's the biggest hurdle for people to go through before they can kind of get any source cards.
Yeah, that's right. And all these sort of design developments and opportunities just have to have it's a good idea.
Last question.
Yeah.
How much of a fire deal would you get? And ask for
in the goal, how much?
That's a fire deal.
The way we design the product is very configurable, so we can, the minimum is two trays, and we can design the trays and then take the boxes out and just use fiber nets. And yeah, it depends on what process is going on. So we based our industrial design aspect on watermelons, so we figured that was the last thing that people were able to lift and grow. And it's that was sort of our mock-up group. And then as well as the rest of the system, we designed the carbon aspect. And also suggested that we're using vehicles to transport huge quantities. So, but the base model is just one variation.
So, at this point, it's aimed to just support the low volume, high frequency pickups. So, bicycles being like quite a fast mode of transport, but only carrying small yields per load.
So, you, in order for this model to work, actually, you saw the delivery issue, you also have to solve the national demand supply.
Yeah.
So which one is more carry more risk in your market?
I was
imagine the demand and risk. Like that's wrong, you know, you have to access vegetable, but the user has to be satisfied with the product. So this is a cooked product before you even see it. You deliver to the restaurant and how you get into the restaurant to be happy with what you get.
Okay. Well, the challenge for us is it's impossible to tackle separately from the design source of the network. So it really came down to us providing the infrastructure in place to support that. And having these different levels of tiers for users to facilitate their transport.
And so having the application there is a social aspect to it as well, where the restaurant owners can communicate to growers to provide advice or even suggestions. So they could say, oh, that's fast fashion wine or scratch this sort of out, or alternatively, they could come up with something new on the menu which requires a different fruit vegetable that they can put into production.
Like in a way, the best producer.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And the idea is that it's not
higher than this last point. But I don't know about security. In India, we have certain bicycles, but they were the capacity was not flexible. For example, if you have to carry more quantity of food, then you can make several stacks of the tray on a single bicycle. So is there anything, any such flexibility in your design that
Yeah, there is, yeah. So the configuration we showed with the front and back tray, the boxes stack in essence to each other, both for storage and handling as well as the wire. And it's really dictated by the weight. And the quality is more transport on time. But our idea is that once you get past a certain quantity and amount of produce and weight, smaller trips will be able to use the house.
Okay, thank you.
One more.
We'll move on with the next question.
All right.
Hey, everybody.
We can still discuss it in the thing. So we have one more about food preservation project.